veteran seniors returning and new additions that
sophomores.
And
convenient size.
Thank you. What's your most embarrassing moment?
Well, it was when I drove into the hole at Minimart.
What's your most embarrassing moment?
My most embarrassing moment was when the Falcon dedicated a song to me at last year's talent show.
Hillbilly Hound. Okay. Go, ask you, Mommy.
What's your favorite hangout?
Hillbilly Hound.
What's your favorite hangout?
Hillbilly Hound.
What's your most embarrassing moment?
My most embarrassing moment is when I was at Western and I fell and I ripped my pantyhose and I had to turn my dress around backwards and I got up and waved to everybody. I was fixing to go across the street. It was horrible. There's cars lined up and that's okay. That's good.
Go, Bonnie.
What's your most embarrassing moment?
My most embarrassing moment was when I was out with this guy that I really liked and I was sitting there and I was talking to him. I had a glass of Coke sitting in front of me, the straw sticking out, and I was trying to talk to him and take a drink at the same time without looking at my straw. So I bent down to take a drink, and while I was looking at him, and I stuck the straw up my nose, and he never asked me out.
Lovely kids.
Okay.
Why do you like being a teacher?
These lovely kids that I have to teach and deal with daily is the reason.
What's your favorite hangout?
Right here at ECHS.
Best thing you like about this school?
I'd probably say it has to be the privilege of coaching Lonnie Winston and Darren Doyle in one season. That's just more than one person could ask.
What's your favorite hangout?
Cruise around Glasgow.
I think I can ask you the question first. Bowling Green.
What's your favorite hangout?
Bowling Green.
Bobby, come here.
Yeah. You ready?
Go ahead.
What's your favorite hangout?
Probably up there at Joe's Pool Hall.
What's your favorite hangout?
I'd say it's probably up there at Joe's Pool Hall. It's a nice place to hang out at.
But I bet they don't ever.
Well, we better keep going then.
Where y'all gonna go film now?
I think they're going English rooms.
Interview people.
What's that like, Miss Gags?
What's your favorite hangout?
My favorite hangout is the bathroom down here by Mr. Johnson's room. It's pretty cool down there.
Right.
could you take Darren with you?
What's your favorite hangout?
I don't know.
What's your favorite hangout?
Ricky Houghton's apartment.
What's your favorite hangout?
Gas station bathrooms.
What's your favorite hangout?
The moon.
What's your favorite hangout?
Nolan Lake, and up in a river above the lake.
What's your favorite hangout?
Linda's place in Bee Spring.
What's your best moment?
When the girls won district for the first time.
What's your favorite hangout? Green. What's your favorite hangout?
Over here by the big trophy over here.
I'm not.
See moment. But my favorite hangout, I like to sit up at the pig pen market and sip RCs and eat moon pies.
What's your most embarrassing moment?
Well, I was at Jimmy Highball's party, and I had to go to the bathroom real bad, and I went so bad that I tore the door off the hinges.
Most embarrassing moment?
My most embarrassing moment is probably the day that I let Ed Rich shave my mustache before the whole school. That's probably it. It's where you get your mouth, get you in trouble, you say something before it.
Do you tell us your favorite hangout?
Hooters.
Yes, could you please tell us your favorite hangout?
The Sunfish Mall.
What's your favorite hangout?
Linda's Place.
Could you please tell us your favorite hangout?
My favorite hangout is Roses in Bowling Green.
Could you please tell us your favorite hangout?
Dollar Store.
Favorite hangout?
Brian Prudy's house.
Could you please tell us your favorite hangout? What's your favorite hangout?
Lampy Park. The guys are so good looking there.
Not being able to say this.
What's your most embarrassing moment?
We went on a field trip to Western and the bus went there.
Okay, you go. John Sanders, what's your favorite hangout?
Well, if I had a hangout, I guess it would be the minute mark, but I don't got a hangout.
What's your favorite high school memory?
Going to prom last year.
Come on. Just video camera. Come on, Bubba.
I don't like video camera.
Willie?
What did I say?
Willie, you love Stacy?
Hey,
don't slide around.
Yeah, I bet you. She's a pretty girl, ain't she? Hi.
Hi.
What about her, Mr. Huffman? It's Chad. Stuart.
If we went to school, I'd moan that damn thing.
Shh, it's on, Chad. Come on.
Oh, well, pardon me.
From the parking lot of Edmonson County High School. The big ECHS right there.
Sean, please don't do that.
Stuart, give me that.
What?
What's your favorite hangout?
Western football field!
Oh, man. What's your favorite hangout?
Football field.
What's your favorite hangout?
My garage is there at the house. I like to work on my truck.
Fuckers got green teeth. What's your favorite hangout?
My garage is there at the house. I like to work on my trucks.
What's your favorite hangout? What's your most embarrassing moment?
I guess when I was a freshman and I got choked on a Jolly Rancher. And we was watching a Heimlich maneuver, a video of a Heimlich maneuver, and no one in the class was watching it because they was paying attention to me and Michael Thompson. And I got choked and started turning purple and spit started running around my mouth. And finally, the Jolly Rancher flew out of my mouth. Then Miss Decker looked at me like I was crazy.
What's your favorite hangout?
My favorite hangout is my house with Jared.
What's your most embarrassing moment?
My most embarrassing moment was we was at a softball game and Sherry Jones, me, and Meredith Webb broke a bench.
What's your most memorable moment? What's your most embarrassing moment?
My most embarrassing moment was when me, Meredith Webb, Farley now, and Sherry Jones were sitting on a bench at a softball game in the dugout and the bench broke. It was really terrible because everybody laughed.
What's this for?
What's your favorite hangout?
I guess the A room since I'm in there all the time.
Thank you.
somebody something, please?
I think you need to get in the floor, Larry. Larry.
Look at this big
one. Oh, sorry!
We didn't want to
participate. Okay, we're going to be tapping you for about 10 seconds. Anything you want for about 10 seconds, go ahead.
10 seconds? Move, baby.
Don't touch me there.
Okay, haven't touched me. I'm up to the tip.
Get your head down.
Note that says the King of Norway. Now at the point when all the Norwegian army were running away, then when the king came onto the field, they immediately stopped running because they had a leader back. Yes, Kip. No, Kip.
Bye.
Live. Won't be live when you see this tape.
Live now.
Sure is live now.
Oh yeah. There are helicopters passing above. Here in Mogadishu.
This is where the bomb went off.
Hey. And, oh God, we're all down. It's still taping. Mr. Stass is talking to us. This is real, folks. This is real. This is not a drill. This is not a test. The attention signal you just heard is fixing to be followed by special news and instructions. This is an actual taping. The live tornado drill. This is not a test.
Make a dedication. Tell my mom I love her.
Carl, mother.
Yeah, you
This is live.
Really, it is. It's exactly.
Yeah.
10:20.
No. I'm taping now. This is.
It's approximately 10:20 on a Friday morning.
Yet it's black as night outside, Joe.
It's because it's gonna be a hellish nightmare.
The fury of God is upon us.
Oh God, we're all gonna die.
This is, you know, this is real.
Yeah, I know. This is real.
Remember what I asked you a while ago?
Y'all won't come down this way, son?
Left leg.
Now.
Oh, it's hurting my darn knees. Don't be able to take for a while.
Extend right leg. Left leg.
Aaron, you want that cover for a while? I think we need this from another person's point of view here.
And we're going to pass the camera over here to Joe,
still taping live. This is the actual footage of the live tornado drill from my point of view.
Even between my legs, so you can see the lockers.
See, I am actually now in the stance in case bricks fall on my head, which would probably break the camera, which would be a great laugh. I can hear the wind blowing outside.
Dad, I think there's a hole in the roof. I'm not sure. I'll just be glad when this is over. Yeah, I'm gonna pass this back to Dad because I'm fearing for my life now.
Has anybody seen Toto?
Toto was last reported missing.
Aaron's filming this.
Has anybody seen Toto?
And at our last count, there were 76 people dead.
We have just been reported that Greenwood Mall has been destroyed.
And Toto was last seen there.
Greenwood Mall is destroyed. That's what they had just said. It is unofficial. So we don't know how severe this storm can be. We're kneeling down here. This is tornado drill cam. This is what you'll see. This is what you see when you're in a tornado drill.
Yeah.
I don't care.
Can we?
People, if your knees are bothering you, y'all can turn around and set up against the wall, lean up against the wall.
And we just got permission from a school official. We can sit down now. As you can clearly see, everybody's down here.
This is all the many innocent students that could be dead, but God has spared their life yet.
It's a pretty tragic thing. There's Miss Campbell, but I don't think even five tornadoes could beat her.
Mr. Phil Rich just told us that on News Center 13, they said this tornado was moving northeast from Warren County, and for all you people that failed geography, that's like Edmonson County.
That was the voice of Mr. Scott Burton.
That was Scott Burton.
As you can see,
a six-year senior here.
As you can see, the clock clearly says it's 10:26 a.m., and yet, if you look outside, it's dark as night. That clearly means that the weather's not good. For you people don't know much about weather.
Where's Jimbo and Daisy, man? I don't want to die without him.
Here's a special message. Maybe there's going to be something on there. Maybe. The kids are scared, yet they're making jokes. Like this camera here, it's all a big joke. I'm not taking any of this serious. There's Miss Campbell, and there's Miss Hadler. Maybe the tornado will take them along. And here's a student teacher who's not any bigger than Toto. Even if she... Special news bulletin, right?
There's a tornado warning in Warren County.
And he is in Warren County, everybody.
I don't
know why the
Hey, this is serious. This is serious. Stop it. Stop. This is serious. Serious.
Campbell. Yes. Why don't
you know
where the
tornado is? I just want to graduate.
How many people have the guts to have this camera going during a tornado drill? I tell you what, not too many. There's Miss Campbell, our poor English teacher. She's She's, her mind is in heaven.
Hey, we're coming to meet you, Kurt. Kurt Colbain. We're coming, baby. All the innocent children that could be dead before the day's over. It's tragic.
It's a tragedy. And I don't care. I hope this tornado keeps coming as long as we don't have to study Macbeth. Oh, video cameras are great.
Yeah, but that's commercial.
You see them killing the wheel. The force is holding strong.
I'm gonna call my mom. Good morning, Joe.
We're gonna take a break and we'll be back right after. Steve Woodcock is dead.
Oh,
gosh. They've just confirmed that Steve Woodcock is dead. He's dead, oh God. Steve Woodcock. Oh Lord, have mercy. Steve Woodcock is now dead. Miss Linda just said. Miss Linda, there she is right there. She's just confirmed that Steve Woodcock is dead.
Look at stop raining.
They're looking for him now. They can't even find his body. They are looking for his body now. Steve Woodcock, his folks, has been confirmed dead, thus raising the death toll to 77.
The latest news is Don Quinton.
There's the woman right there. She confirmed Steve Woodcock's dead.
See this? You see the fear in my eyes?
Steve Woodcock, Edmonson
County High School, with the live tornado.
Joe! The tornado picked a cow up, moved in. Into Miss Campbell's room, man. Look.
A cow.
Oh, it's Miss Campbell. Oh, my God. Oh, no. Miss Campbell, you're letting me. Look.
What is
it's
oh,
showing a naked man on television.
Miss Campbell is being burned alive here, folks. I don't know. I think
let's get his opinion on it.
And there's Howard White. Look at that behind. Let's get a close-up. We're going wide angle here. That stuff like this is what we're going to miss after this tornado wreaks havoc across the land. Don't try this at home, kids. You should never, ever get your parents' video camera out without their permission, especially during a tornado. This is horrible. This is absolutely horrible.
I wish I was able
to like. No, I ain't lying. We've only got half the battery left, and now the time is 10:34 a.m., and yet, as you look outside, it's as dark as night. It is as dark as night. And it's dark. There's Phil Rich. He's trying to comfort the ones who've lost loved ones and friends in this horrible disaster. Yes, look at him, folks. He's fearless. Look at that power belt buckle he's got on there. Rich.
Come on, and we was going shopping.
There he is. Look at that. Look at him. He's fearless. Absolutely fearless. That's amazing.
It's good to know they're still here.
That's right. That's right there is. We'll be back after this. We're back on camera. Oh my God, there's been a power failure. We can't see anything. There's crap going everywhere. Kids are dying. There's bodies flying everywhere. But I'm sorry. There was just the lens. The lens was on the cover. It's okay. Everybody's still here. There's Scott and Joe. And there's Kip way down there. He's horribly troubled by this disaster. You can tell by looking at him. He don't even want to be on the camera. And Derek, he's out of AE today.
I would like to say a few words to Toto. Okay.
There they are down there. They're praying down there, I think. What are they doing?
Something like that.
I don't know what they're hurling. They're gambling, I think. They're playing jacks. They're comparing ankles or something.
Every senior's idea of high school.
This is how you get out of College Mount English Macbeth. This is it. Karen Mulcahy. Somebody hollering my name?
Yes, it was me. Hey, Darren.
Oh, yeah, what?
I just wanted to tell you. I love you.
Hey, Sean.
And there's Carol Hatler, folks. She is directing the traffic. She's telling everybody how to die, as if they don't already know. Thanks, Carol. Thanks a lot.
A live message from Joe Miller.
I would just like to say, for the record, that I do believe that this act of nature is its own little way of getting back at us for what we've done for the American gray squirrel and how we've destroyed its habitat.
Almost definitely.
I believe nature does have its own little ways of repaying us.
Yes.
And I do believe this is it.
Excellent message from
1 mile down already and 76 people dead.
77, I think.
77 at last count.
Steve Woodcock's death, as this one has just come and told us.
Got it. It's awful. And Toto, he's gone too.
Toto's gone.
Nobody knows where Toto is at. We don't know if he's dead yet.
Toto's last seen to Greenwood Mall, folks, as we've
Greenwood
heard,
Mall.
It's been destroyed. And I will take a look at the clock again. It's 10:37, 4 minutes from our last, 3 minutes from our last date, a.m. And yet, as you can see, it's black as night outside. It is black as night. That is dark, baby. Okay, we'll be back. And you know, they said if you hear a train,
hey, what is that?
There's a train. And this is a roof that's fixing to fall on us, folks.
There's Joanne Fulkerson patrolling the hallways. She is turning the electricity off. No one is typing. But before we went out in the hall, she made sure all of her typewriters were indeed covered up. And all the desks were back in the rows. Thank you.
Here's Scott Barton with the special damage report.
As you can see, right down here on this ceiling, we have extensive damage already to the roof. I don't know if this thing's gonna hold up much longer. That's a horrible gash. A chunk out of the roof there. It's already fell on these kids right here. And that's why these kids are turning around the opposite way. Because they've broken their arms.
That's some heavy stuff in Burgess.
That sure is. That weighs about 5 billion pounds right there.
At least 5 billion pounds. If you want to fall and handle right now, she'd be a goner. I mean, she's a heavy woman, but I mean, she just couldn't stand.
I tell you what, she better get out. She better, on second thoughts, just let her stand there. Okay. Folks, this is how you handle a tornado.
Kick back, drink your Diet RC.
Look at them. They're just relaxed, hands in pockets.
As Bobby Joe always is.
I don't think that's
drinking
a
Diet Cola.
Yeah,
look at him. They're talking about typewriters, having your feet on the floor, good posture, wrists off the keyboard.
I don't know about you, Mr. Joe, but you notice the clash
in
clothing styles of these two teachers?
Yes, here's one teacher. Look at the
one teacher in Adidas, one in Nike,
and the other
pumps, flats, pumps. Not like Reebok pumps, you know.
The modern jeans that the students like to wear.
And the nice jeans. Little web belt.
Levi's, as a matter of fact.
And a nice little duck head shirt.
But yet, another dead, folks. Jeremy Ray is now dead. They just told us on the intercom, Jeremy Ray is dead. That raises the death count to 78.
Nine.
Here comes another teacher down here.
Sporting the
wanting to
warm up
yell at
outfit.
Everybody. Try to tell us how to act in this stupid thing. She needs to just get back in a room where she belongs.
Taking care of her own students.
Yeah, exactly. They're probably scared to death right now. We've got 15 teachers on this wing already. Thanks. We don't need you. You can leave. Thanks. Her mother is dead. Her brother just died. She's going around the corner.
That's not very nice.
That's her right there. Her brother just died.
Oh, my Lord. Hey, Miss Stacy's in labor. Miss Stacy's in labor.
Here we have a pregnant lady. She's about to have a baby.
She must be taking this hard, Mr. Stacy.
Look at that belly. Miss Stacy, could you step out in the hall, please?
Miss Stacy.
Could you step out here? There she is. Oh.
She hasn't got it on.
No, I don't. What is this? Here, buddy. What is this? There is Sarah Joe's close-up right there. She didn't think I had it on. How about that?
EJS News is taking over, baby.
We ought to get a Pulitzer Prize for this. Excellent coverage of Tornado 90. It's a tornado. This ain't no cakewalk, buddy. Oh. Bobby Duncan, look at him. Look how he's handling. Acting like it's a breeze. Actually, it's a breeze, all right. It's a pretty big, hefty breeze.
a big dang breeze is what it is. So we're going to take a break. We'll be back. We just had a report from one of the teachers.
Miss Belinda Rickett just informed us that we need to quiet down and get settled. But the stuff is getting pretty close here. We could be receiving some information on how better handle with this. See, we need one of those stabilizers for this camera. It's a,
yeah,
little,
no,
jumpy.
It's a little jumpy.
Our cameraman is not very good.
That's because the wind's picking up. I wanted to put her freaking 2 cents in. What do you say about it, huh? Look at that.
The hospital now.
Here they go. They're going to the hospital. He's lost his...
He doesn't look that injured, but trust me, he is hurt.
He's bruised on the inside, though.
Possible concussion.
Oh, it's here's the hero coming down the hall. He's going to save everybody. Here he is.
My outlook on this situation is he will save 90 lives today.
Oh, definitely, Scott.
At least 90 lives.
At least. We're talking a major.
He'll pack
hero,
50 out at one time on 25 in each arm.
He's fearless.
He's the man with
his
plan with a stick in his hand.
Look at his eyes. Just look at him.
Fearless. Fearless.
Absolutely.
This is a picture of the seal that's going to fall on us and kill us all. I just hope the sprinklers don't go off and mess up my hair. Because if my hair gets a little wet, it curls up like crap.
Mine either, because I have this extremely difficult hairdo to deal with.
And if you don't know what hairdo he's talking about,
I mean, it takes me hours to fix this sucker every morning. I mean, I'm talking about lots of jerry curl. Lots of jerry curl.
It's so
long that stuff is.
I mean, it's getting out there. It must, what, a 16th of an inch long by now?
At least 16.
Look at the soul glow.
Okay, here we are. This is the floor. This is...
Get in the window!
Cameraman.
More footage.
More live footage.
Oh, God, somebody's...
Bootage!
Oh, my God, somebody's bootage just fell off.
Oh, God.
Foot.
That was carried in for Tennessee.
I'm sorry, that wasn't somebody's boot. That's somebody's foot. Still attached. That was Kip Housen's foot. But at least he's not dead.
No, you always hurt.
Winds get up so fast that like straw sticks in solid arms.
That's right.
Maybe that's what's in my ribs now.
There must be some kind of party going on in here because all the teachers are coming out of here. And the last person down is pregnant, so there's no telling what's been going on in there. And they're using some kind of sign language here. Some kind of sign language because they're trying to hear the announcements and special reports. There you can see she's using sign language. Well, she stopped there for a minute. There she goes again. Oh, she's just coughing, covering up her mouth. Oh, well, that's her. Some more footage here, folks. This is live footage. And she's either got a real dark hairy leg or some pantyhose on. Live update, we're going over here to Scott Burton.
Getting closer to lunchtime now. Just wondering how they're going to feed us. They can't leave us out here without
that's
any food.
That's a good point.
And
that's
we are all definitely starving to death. Just ask these young ladies.
Here comes another one.
Definitely getting mad.
Here she goes. She's going to check up on everybody. Yeah. She needs to get back there with their kids. What's she want now? Let's see what she wants.
Sit down. Lindsay York is coming through.
She just walks. Okay, folks, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to attempt to get up and walk around the school and get some more coverage because we basically know what's going on here. Okay, now the teacher's on break. Here we go.
Live update from the other hall.
I made it to the other hall without being caught.
I do believe we can make
it. Nobody, we're not for sure how many deaths are in this end of the hall. There's some teachers. Who is that? There's
the head man. Head man.
There's Jamie Carnes.
Get a live shot of you coming down the hall.
Okay. All these kids are still alive. Good. The ceiling is okay. There's a little gap right there. Uh-oh.
The gap is sucking the ceiling up.
I don't know.
But
I don't know how that happened.
This damage is less extensive than
there's
Mr. Fulkerson.
I'm going to have to try to get away from Mr. Fulkerson. If I can scoot around this wall without her seeing me. Okay.
I believe the secret is to scoot through the library.
That's exactly right, Scott. Okay. We're in the library. This is library. Nothing's going on in here. I don't think any teachers are watching. Oh, we got some kids playing ball over here. Hey, there's Miss Ricketts.
We're busted, come on.
And we've been busted. We've been ordered to sit back down. She jumped all over me.
Trying to survive the storm. I believe they're making out their will or discussing their differences, possibly trying to resolve everything before the end. As you can see, she has her hand on some sort of comfort.
Whose knee is that?
Don't trust the battery eject button.
Hey. No.
You face. You face.
Okay.
That's
Mr.
Right.
Jamie Carr.
A twister, a cloud.
This is the man.
Thank you, Mr. Carnes.
Now we're going live to Joe Miller.
We have been informed of the dangers of filming such an incident as this, and we are aware of this risk, and we shall uphold our duties as journal, as our duties in journalism. I'm so shooken up from this whole incident. Shaking up. I can't even get my grammar right. I just can't grasp the words, but they just fail to come to me. But I'm sure if we ask Ms. Campbell, she could tell me.
But you may not realize the chances we are taking here and trying to get these up. I'm not even in this like little whatever class it is, but I put my life on
that's
the
exactly
line
right,
to help them out, to be a guest
Scott,
anchor this
we
week.
We appreciate it, Scott, because we need all the help we can get. If it was more like you, the world would be
I mean, there's too
place.
Many cowards around. Look at all these people just
and
hunkered
I'm just
over.
An innocent bystander.
Everyone
that's
is
right,
in
Kip.
Tears. Everyone in tears, but
Kip's
see,
not doing nothing, but he's not afraid.
No.
No, he's not.
And here they are.
That's cute. Yep.
And they're playing little girly games, patty jack, flappy wad, whatever that is. What have you. They're doing cards, old maid. We showed you the ball game. It's right across the hall there with the kids playing tennis ball or something. I hope that was a tennis ball. We're going to take another update. Go ahead, Joe. Okay.
I have just been informed by Miss Campbell that she had just called the hospital to check on her father, and she was informed that they have moved all the patients out of the rooms into the hall, so it's still a very critical situation.
Yeah, because there's old people down doing what we're doing. That's hard on their old bones and stuff.
And
they're probably breaking arms and legs. That's what they
are
like being jerked out of their arms.
Yeah, and we just hope and pray that this is over soon, because we're really feeling for the people that are in a worse situation than
that's
we
exactly
are.
That's exactly right.
And we understand that, and we can just be comforted by the fact that we're not the only ones, but we also
yes.
have to feel for them.
And another special report,
the people, the old fogies that are at the hospital now that are being bowed down in the hall, they're having to mess
up. Shauna Davis is now dead, folks. Another death. That's rising the death toll to 80 students. 80 students. 81 students, I'm sorry. There's 81 confirmed dead. Back to our report about the hospital. All the old people that are bowed down in the halls, it's a big mess because they're having to wire out their, bring out their heart monitors and their IV, and there's all kinds of stuff. And there's stuff falling over and hitting them on the head, and 17 people have already died because of accidents at the hall. And there's that train again. There's that train again.
Ding, 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 ding,
ding, ding.
I wonder what Floyd would say about us
sitting
in the halls like this when we were storming back.
I don't know, Joe.
He'd probably say, what are they doing sitting
that's exactly right.
Here's our,
hey, Sean.
No, Shauna Davis is not dead.
Shauna Davis is not dead. She just walked out of the typing room. She was only missing, but
she was putting the cover back on.
She has been found, and she is now being sent to the hospital. She's being flown by Skyline. Everything's getting quiet. I don't know why.
It's always the time of the storm.
And, oh, well, there's nothing else. Uh-oh, here's an announcement. Lucille the janitor. Oh, my God, she's dead. She is dead. Lucille is dead.
81 students, one janitor. What's coming next?
All we can pray for.
Wilkerson is frantically pacing the hall.
And I don't know what's going on now. There's kids There's kids gathering over here. Let's pop this lens cover off.
They're looking for some sort of special report.
Rhoda, the report, please.
There's wind damage at Fairdale and Fire Creek in Louisville. Their trailer's turned over and wind damage just filled other buildings.
Oh, whoopee, wind damage. This is the tornado here.
Whoopee freaking dude.
If you don't believe it.
This is what you see when you're in a tornado. This is what you see when you're in a tornado.
How do you like Zoom?
Oh, there's Sarah Joe Alexander. Very, very, very close up here.
Miss Campbell's got some food.
I never claimed to be like a journalism dude, so.
Campbell's got some rations.
Let's zoom in here.
We have Sarah Joe so close up you can see the boogers in her nostrils.
Hello, how are you? Oh, tornado's really getting this guy. Oh, there's Norman Tindall. He seems to be taking this very well. And oh my lord, are they standing up? I believe if they are standing up, we have just as much right as they do here in this school. So. Oh, this is, yes, Ryan.
Oh, we just had a report.
Whoa. Orders being taken here from Miss Hatler that we should all sit down and take this matter more seriously. Oh my lord, this is definitely student violence here. She is abusing these students very terribly. Oh, she stumbled over. Hear what?
Oh, we're going live to WBKO.
It hit
Here's Bucktooth Chris Allen right here live.
Well, Susan, it's been a very active morning, as you well know, here in South Central Kentucky. It's been very busy, very hurried, and still a lot of activity going on across South Central Kentucky. By no means has the severe weather let up in any form or fashion. Matter of fact, let's take a look at some of the maps that we have up for you now as far as severe thunderstorm warnings. This one we spoke of just a few minutes ago, severe thunderstorm warning in effect until 11:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time, 12:15 p.m. Central Eastern Time for persons in Greene and Taylor counties. And now we have a new severe thunderstorm warning in effect. This one just issued moments ago. This one is in effect until 11:30 a.m. Central Time for Barron, Allen, and Monroe County. So Barron, Allen, and Monroe County, now there's a severe thunderstorm warning until 11:30 a.m. We're going to go to Skywatch 13 radar right now. I want to show you the intense line of thunderstorms as they're moving through the area. You can see that on the radar, severe thunderstorms moving through Queens, Hart, Edmonson, still on the southeast of the city. Not moving much of any place, and that is causing all the problems. Now, here is a Skywatch 13 Doppler radar. Now, this is a new radar.
Well, it looks okay. Nobody's dying now. It's starting to get a little lighter outside. There's somebody's head. See, the sky's a little, it's getting a little brighter. So it's still raining, but that's okay. I'm talking to all the innocent viewers at home who are watching this live news report on tape. We'll take another break and we'll be back after you. And there's David Stice giving us the okay that everything is okay. It's over, folks. Thank Jesus that it's over. And look at all the kids that are still alive.
Look at them all. They're frolicking. They're all alive. Everybody's okay. Great. Everybody's okay. Even Katie. Thank you, Jesus.
Still got you.
I'm studying hard.
What?
No,
Hold me up here. Class of 98.
They're going out when I retire. Say hi. Thank you. Kenna, say hi there.
What about the again and Ray-Ban? The N and the N. And again and Ray-Ban. Do you want the K in spoken to go with the K in dark and speak? Dark, spoken, and broken. You've got two more K's there. Third line, first word.
How do you get it off?
You gotta push the record button.
Can you just push the red button again? Can you push the red button again to turn it off?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll see.
No.
How are you doing now, boy?
15!
Five. Make sure you get
ow!
Everybody way better this time, y'all. It's been 15
minutes.
Bye.
Bye.
What do you
want to do?
Can I get a
spider?
She was.
Hey, gotta wave. Everybody wave the camera.
Wave.
Smile, wave.
Wave.
Wave your hat.
This is the way.
Aware, that's right. Anyone have any other answers? Knowledgeable? In the know?
You could be anywhere.
Is the Beaver 101. Everything's 101 is great on 101.
That's true. In other words, the commons
area.
That's where
commons
the commons area.
We communicate.
The commons. This is the commons. It's the position stand.
You probably gotta talk louder.
Bandarama. The Bahama.
Hello, little person.
Where I hunkered down for the tornado drill today.
It's famous.
Let me show you.
Well, show me.
Show it.
It's hard to walk.
This is where I hunkered down for the tornado drill.
And right there is where I was, right there.
I was on the other side of the library. We're walking.
Keep
walking
down the hall.
Go to the login, it's fun.
We're wasting.
Cool Charlie Brooks.
Yeah. I left you doing something.
Just smile away. Recording.
Do something.
That's not real.
Oh. You fake?
Ooh. Ooh. Sweet.
Look at where I'm going to be.
Alicia. There's a brand new revolver. Go ahead.
The ag wing. Left side of the ag wing.
I agree.